we are going to discuss how can we calculate the canonical cover of functional dependencies. This topic is very important. See, in canonical cover, it will be denoted by FC, C will come in the suffix. On functional dependencies, F will contain no extraneous functional dependencies. This algorithm to compute FC is as follows. That means one set of functional dependency, let it be capital F, will be given to us. So F is containing set of functional dependencies which are given to us. Some functional dependencies within that set might be redundant, might be having some redundant or extraneous attributes. So in case of canonical cover of FC, which will be obtained from F, there will be no redundant functional dependencies will be there, and there will be no extraneous attribute either on the left hand side or on the right hand side of considering all the functional dependencies. So that is the minimal cover of F, will be known as canonical cover of F, and it will be denoted by FC. So now let us go through one algorithm with the help of which we shall explain that one. So at first, FC is equal to F. So whatever the functional dependency set is given to us, we shall keep this one in FC. Repeat, and this one is until. So this total block is going to get executed. So I'm marking this one here. Okay. Use the union rule to replace any functional dependency with in FC of the form alpha 1 produces beta 1 and alpha 1 produces beta 2. With alpha 1 produces beta 1, beta 2. So that means we are going to apply our union rule. So alpha 1 produces beta 1 and alpha 1 produces beta 2. That means the left hand side of these two functional dependencies are same and they are nothing but alpha 1. Then please apply the union rule. So I shall be going for alpha 1 produces or alpha 1 determines beta 1 and beta 2. So that will replace these two functional dependencies. Okay. Find functional dependency alpha determines beta in FC with an extraneous attribute either in alpha or in beta. That means I shall have to find that whether there is some extraneous attribute either in alpha or in beta in a functional dependency alpha determines beta, which is already there considered in FC, and we shall have to find for that. We shall have to search for that. If an extraneous attribute is found, then delete it from alpha determines beta. So in this way, we are making our functional dependency set minimal, optimal, and in this way, we are going to get this FC, that is a canonical cover of F. So these are the rules are there. This is the algorithm, and this process will be continued until FC does not change. So if FC go on changing, then the process will be continued. So now let us come to this part. An attribute of a functional dependency is said to be extraneous if we remove it without changing the closure of the set of functional dependencies. That means one attribute will be considered as a redundant attribute or extraneous attribute either appearing on the left hand side or right hand side. Then after removal of that attribute, if you go for the closure set of FDs, I'll be getting back all the functional dependencies as it is. Consider one functional dependency alpha determines beta. So here we are going for explicit study whether this extraneous attribute A is occurring on the left hand side or on the right hand side of the functional dependency. So consider one FD alpha determines beta in F, and an attribute A is extraneous, redundant. So we are having following cases. Case number one, if A belongs to alpha, that means A is occurring on the left hand side of the functional dependency. Case 2, if A belongs to beta, that means the extraneous attribute A is belonging to the right hand side of the functional dependency. So let us go one by one. So if A belongs to alpha, then F dash implies that is F minus alpha determines beta. So that functional dependency will be taken out, will be discarded from F. Union alpha minus A determines beta, because A was redundant in alpha as A was redundant in alpha. So, alpha minus A, so that reduced left hand side will determine beta accordingly, and that has to be included in our FC, in our F dash. If A belongs to beta, that means beta is containing the extraneous attribute A, that is the right hand side of the functional dependency, then F dash implies F minus alpha determines beta. So, alpha determines beta, that functional dependency will be discarded from F, union alpha determines beta minus A. So, on the right hand side, the A has to be discarded. To compute alpha dash, if you compute the alpha plus rather, that is the closer, under F dash, if alpha plus includes A, that indicates that A is extraneous in beta. So, now in case of beta, if you eliminate A and if you go for alpha plus, that is the closer of alpha, and if you find that in the closer set, ultimately you are getting A included, that means in beta, A was redundant. So, these are the respective study we have done. Now, we are making a note, that means what we are getting. A canonical cover FC will have, so two things. One, no FD in FC contains an extraneous attribute either on the left hand side or on the right hand side. Each left hand side of a functional dependency in FC is unique because already we have merged them to have this one. So, I am not going to find any two functional dependencies whose left hand sides are same. So, each and every functional dependency in the canonical cover FC will have distinct or unique left hand side. So, let us go for some example for the better understanding. So, here is two examples we are going to give. So, in F, let us suppose this is the F given to us, A determines B, B determines C, and A determines CD. So, from A determines B and B determines C, you can easily write A determines C. So, here you see this A determines CD is there. So, C is redundant because already you know that using transitivity rule that A determines C. So, as C is redundant on the right hand side of A determines CD, so in the canonical cover of the functional dependencies, let it be FC, will be having this A determines B, B determines C, and A determines D. So, that means the C has been eliminated because C was an extraneous attribute on the right hand side of the functional dependency A determines CD. So, let us take another example here. If F is equal to A determines B, B determines C, and AC determines D. So, now here you see A determines B and B determines C means A determines C if we apply the transitivity rule. So, now AC, A determines C, so AC determines D means C is redundant on the left hand side of the functional dependency AC determines D because A determines C. So, AC determines D means actually A determines D. So, we can write that the canonical cover of this functional dependency set will be A determines B will be there as it is, B determines C will be there as it is, and this AC determines D will be reduced to A determines D. So, in this way we have discussed what is a canonical cover of functional dependencies, what are the respective notes we should maintain, and what is the respective algorithm with the help of which from F we can derive our FC, and also some examples for the doubt clearing, so that we should know that what the algorithms are saying and how the process is getting carried out. Thanks for watching this video.